का दिन आज है। आज जिस तरह तुम दूल्हा बने हो, तुम रश्के मलाइका बन चुके हो।
How can we welcome the Ramadan, especially for Ummat Muslimah, in this Ramadan? How can we celebrate the Ramadan?
I think after COVID-19, many people have suffered a lot, especially last year. Unfortunately, in Europe and in Britain, it was not possible to have same kind of gathering, same kind of activities, same kind of i'tikaf, in the same way, recitation of Quran in Salatul Tarawih, standing in the masjid. Wow. So it was very difficult time. But Alhamdulillah, this year everything is changed. And now, inshallah, we are waiting for Ramadan with fasting, with five time prayer in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with Salatul Tarawih, with all our normal activities, inshallah. Yes, with some social distancing and with all some precautions. But the time is very different. And this is the great time for us. We have to realize that the time will come. The time will come. Ramadan will be here. We won't be here. The time will come. We will not be in a position to go to the mosque. The time will come that the Ramadan will be waiting for us. We will not be in a position to walk, to go to the mosque, to recite Quran, to stand in the Salatul Tarawih. So the ni'mah of the health and the ni'mah of the siha, which has been granted to us, and the opportunity which was given to us, this is the time. Don't miss this chance. Tomorrow Ramadan will be, but I am not sure I will be there or not. I will be in a position to do something or not. I will be in a position to carry on all these activities or not. So ni'matan maghbunun feehima kathirun minan nas as-sihhatu wal faragh. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we are always misusing two bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, two blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One is the health and one is the time. So this is the time to value it, and we wait for Ramadan, and we should be ready for Ramadan and prepare ourselves well in advance when Ramadan al-Mubarak come, ready for fasting, ready for salat, ready for Taraweeh, and purify ourselves well before Ramadan. And when we meet the guest of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should meet it with our strength of iman, with the purity of our aqeedah, our a'mal. And this is the message of Istiqbal Ramadan today.
What is the message for our young generation, especially for after COVID-19 days and special this Ramadan? How can we change our life?
COVID-19 was a difficult time, as
especially for youngsters.
Yeah, especially for youngsters. The whole world is suffered. This is a message for us. There was a time the people were thinking, now we are very strong, we are very powerful, no one can challenge us. Even some countries were thinking that they are so advanced, they have such, they have a system, no enemies can enter to the borders. And we have a space station, we have control in the space, so we are in a very different level. But one unseen enemy disrupted all these things. And you see, last year, from east to west, from America to Europe, from Europe to African and Asian country, everything closed. No one know what to do. All advancement, technology, modern science, everything was completely helpless to fight against this. Alhamdulillah, the people have struggled, the scientists have struggled, and now we are in a very better position. But the message to us that inna batsha rabbika lashadid, you can run here and there anywhere, but idha jaa ajaluhum la yastakhiruna sa wa la yastaqdimun. When the time come, no one can protect you. When the time come, no one can support you. When the time come, no one can help you. Everything in this world has a specific time. So as a young, don't think you will be with the same power and with the same strength forever. The time will come, there will be no power, no strength. Be ready, do something before this time comes. Whatever you have, realize it, value it, utilize it, and not only make yourself useful and valuable member and citizen of the society, but the obedient servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the purpose of your creation. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. For you beautifying your world, you are struggling day and night. So to beautify your soul, you have to fulfill your duty toward your Lord as the abd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
نماز تراویح بھی قریب اور اس کے لمحات بھی آ رہے ہیں. قرآن کریم کی تلاوت اور نبی پاک صلی اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ وسلم نے قرآن کی اس مہینے میں تلاوت بھی کی ہے اور ترغیب بھی دی ہے, اور ساتھ ساتھ آپ یہ دیکھیں کہ رمضان کے بارے میں اللہ فرماتا ہے کہ یہ وہ مہینہ ہے جس میں اللہ نے قرآن نازل کیا ہے. تو ڈاکٹر علامہ محمد اقبال نے بھی اس طرح اشارہ دیا کہ وہ معزز تھے زمانے میں مسلمہ ہو کر, ہم خوار ہوئے تارے کے قرآن ہو کر. امت کا قرآن کے ساتھ جو کنیکشن کٹتا جا رہا ہے, ہم اس کو دوبارہ کس طرح پال کر سکتے ہیں؟ اتنے انسیڈنٹ گزرنے کے بعد, انسانیت کو اپنے سامنے لقمہ اجل ہوتے ہوئے دیکھنے کے بعد بھی اگر ہمارا تعلق قرآن سے قائم نہ ہو تو کہیں ایسا تو نہیں کہ ہمارے دل سخت ہو گئے؟
ہمارا تعلق قرآن سے ہے تو